You said in your speech today that aid is a very complicated business, if I get it right. Because we are in Romania, and Romania is a new donor state, I would like to ask you to say a few words about the specificity of this region.
I think a lot of it's to do with the relative youth of your development policies over here. There was a significant change after the end of communism, and there was a rebuilding of a whole set of policies and the whole building of society to a large extent, and development policy was not a priority in that. Since joining the European Union, it has become something that these countries have to engage with, and I think that's important to consider that a country like the United Kingdom has got a longer history to reflect upon, and therefore the youth of these countries. I mean, even just Romania has only been a member of the European Union for 8 years. So I think any of the judgments we make about its donor policy have to be considered in light of that time period. So, and I think the main thing is, as I was saying in the presentation, is to try and ensure you have the foundations for a good development policy. So you need the laws, you need the structures in place, you need the expertise. You also need to know that people understand what development policy is. So that is that's something for schools and the education system and universities to consider. And I think if you put all of those together, then it helps to build the policy.
What best practice should we use, in your opinion, in building this policy? From the older member states, not the oldest necessarily, but maybe from the same region with us?
I think that's an interesting question. A lot of the practices of the old donors, to use that term, would not be seen to be good practice. So I think the important thing for Romania is to see and look at what practices are there and then choose the ones that best reflect its situation. Also, they need to consider the fact that you have come through an economic crisis, which is obviously going to temper anything that you're doing. But there is a lot of good examples from the region. And again, as I mentioned in the talk, using the experience of an organization like the DAC or asking questions within the European institutions helps build up the Romanian expertise. But I think that Romania needs to build its own development cooperation to reflect the situation in Romania, and the idea of sort of downloading a model from the UK or Poland or Austria wouldn't necessarily work, because it wouldn't take into consideration your structures, your history, your politics. So I think you can pick and choose like a menu of what's out there, but at the same time use that to reflect on what's the best for Romania.
What about at the European level? This year the Commission launched officially the European Year of Development. What do you think this initiative could bring, anything new in, or maybe awareness, or even a change in the policies? Do you think it will be something important?
I think the European Year for Development is really important about keeping the issue high on the agenda, giving a sort of an impetus to organisations like FOND in Romania that they can organise events like this. I think the conference that's starting very soon in Addis Ababa on financing, the Sustainable Development Goals in New York and the climate change in Paris show why we need a European Year for Development, because this is going to be a significant year that's going to shape the agenda for the next 10, 15 years. And so therefore having the public engaged with this to some extent and putting it high on an agenda can only be a good thing.
And one last question about a problem very actual in this moment regarding Greece. The European Commissioner for Development said recently that Greece might be a beneficiary of humanitarian aid. Do you have an opinion about this possibility?
It's interesting hearing the comments that come out from different officials about Greece. I think clearly development aid is a more long-term planning dealing with the sort of development issues. Humanitarian aid is related to specific crisis events. And I think that with the situation in Greece, there have been a lot of statements made that are designed to elicit a political reaction rather than the reality. So I'm going to... it's hard to... I wouldn't want to call that. I wouldn't see the situation in Greece being the same as an earthquake or a flood or something like that. It's a very serious situation and needs to be carefully considered, but it's a political solution to the problem rather than dealing with the after effects of a natural disaster.